Hello everyone. Let's go through the chapter Discovering Tut, The Saga Continues, written by A.R. Williams. The chapter is taken from the NCERT textbook for class 11, Hornbill. Let's go through the gist of the chapter Discovering Tut, The Saga Continues, written by A.R. Williams. King Tut became an emperor when he was only a teenager. He died also as a teenager. But till this date, we don't know the reason behind his death. That is the reason that his body has been examined repeatedly. A great damage was caused by Howard Carter, the British archaeologist. He wanted to know more about King Tut and his sudden demise. He took out the coffin and kept it open under the blazing heat of the sun. He wanted to melt the raisins which glued King Tut's body with the coffin. And when he was unable to do so, he tried to chisel out body parts, causing grave damage to the body. Egyptians believed in the process of resurrection. They believed in life after death. That is why the Egyptian kings were buried after their death with all the things they loved in their life. King Tut's body was also buried with gold artifacts, necklace, bracelet, board games, razor, linen undergarments, and the cases of food and wine. Now the past of King Tut. Amenhotep III was the father or grandfather of King Tut. He was followed by Amenhotep IV. Amenhotep IV turned a bit crazy and he stopped the worship of Amun God. He started the worship of Aten God. He changed even his name from Amenhotep to Akhenaten. He changed the capital from Thebes to Amarna. He closed the temples of Amun God and smashed idols of Amun God. In this way, he became a bit wacky. You must know about these characters. King Tut, the last heir of a powerful family that had ruled Egypt for centuries. His preserved body was the first to be scanned. Howard Carter, the British archaeologist who in 1922 discovered King Tut's tomb. His search caused great damage to the king's preserved body, as we have already done. Zahir Hawass, the Secretary General of Egypt's Supreme Council of Antiquities. He scanned King Tut's mummy for an accurate forensic reconstruction. Amenhotep III. He was King Tut's father or grandfather, and he was a powerful ruler who ruled for almost four decades. He was followed by Amenhotep IV. He was the one who turned a bit wacky. He promoted the worship of Aten God instead of Amun God, changing his name, changing the capital, and smashing the idols of Amun God and closing the temples of Amun God. Let's understand the highlights of this chapter. Tutankhamun or King Tut died as a teenage pharaoh and was buried laden with gold. He was the last king of a powerful family that ruled Egypt for centuries. Now this is an important point. On 5th January 2005, his mummy was brought out of his tomb and a CT scan was done to ascertain the reason of his death. Multitudes of tourists from around the world came to visit the tomb to pay their respects. Zahir Hawass, Secretary General of Egypt's Supreme Council of Antiquities, said that his mummy was in a very bad condition because of what Carter did to it. Now, Howard Carter was the first person to discover the tomb of King Tut. He was a British archaeologist, and in 1922, he discovered King Tut's tomb. Carter faced difficulty in extracting the mummy out of the coffin. What he did was really strange. He kept the coffin open under the blazing heat of the sun to melt the raisins. When he was unable to do so, he tried to chisel out the body parts and that caused a lot of damage to the body of King Tut. In 1968, an anatomy professor x-rayed the mummy of King Tut and he revealed a very startling, a shocking fact. He claims that the breastbone and the front ribs of the mummy were missing. Amenhotep III was King Tut's father or grandfather, and he was a powerful pharaoh. He was succeeded by Amenhotep IV, and as we have done earlier, that Amenhotep IV promoted the worship of Aten god and stopped the worship of Amun god. He changed even his name to Akhenaten, and he made other changes also, like changing the capital. King Tut's mummy was one of the first mummies to be scanned. The CT scan showed a grey head, neck vertebrae, a hand, several images of the rib cage, and a section of the skull. Zahi Hawass was relieved to find that nothing had gone seriously wrong with the mummy. After their observations when they left, the wind stopped and there was complete silence. Just above the entrance to King Tut's tomb stood Orion, the constellation, watching over the boy king. Let's understand the chapter in the form of question answers. Who was Howard Carter and what was his discovery? So now we know that Howard Carter was a British archaeologist, and after years of searching, he discovered King Tut's tomb in 1922. After 3,300 years after the death of King Tut. Now, King Tut died as a teenager, we know very well. And he was the last ruler of the powerful family that ruled Egypt for centuries. But the surprising fact is that we still don't know the reason behind the death of King Tut. Now, why did King Tut's mummy have to undergo CT scan? So obviously, as the reasons of his death are unknown, they are mysterious, King Tut's body was ordered to be scanned to examine the delayed medical mysteries about his life and death. In 1968, what was the startling fact revealed by a professor of anatomy about King Tut? So do understand that in 1968, more than 40 years after Carter's discovery of King Tut's tomb, a professor of anatomy x-rayed King Tut's mummy, and he revealed the fact that beneath the raisin that layers his chest, his breastbone and front ribs are missing. It has, of course, startled everyone. When King Tut's body was taken out second time in 2005, several tourists from around the world gathered over there. They wanted to pay their homage to King Tut. They watched the mirage on the walls of the burial chamber. Some visitors read from guidebook also, and others stood silently peering at Tut's gilded face. Now, who did point out that the mummy was in a bad condition, and who was responsible for that? So we know now that it was Zahi Hawass, Secretary General of Egypt's Supreme Council of Antiquities, who found out that the mummy happened to be in a very, very bad condition, and the one responsible for that was Carter. And we know that in 1922, Carter had discovered King Tut's tomb, and the two drastic steps he had taken, keeping the coffin open under the blazing heat of the sun and chiseling out the body parts. Why was King Tut's demise a big event, even by royal standards? So King Tut's death, of course, was a big event. Even by royal standards, he was the last ruler in his family line. His funeral was the death bell of a dynasty that ruled in Egypt for centuries. The big event is because of the fact that he died unexpectedly at young age. The particulars of his passing away and its aftermath are not clear. In fact, there are some people who think that King Tut's untimely death is actually Pharaoh's curse. We know very well that Amenhotep IV changed his name from Amenhotep to Akhenaten. He stopped the worship of Amun god and started the worship of Aten god. After him, some unknown ruler came. After that, a young Tutankhaten took the throne, and he changed his name also to Tutankhamun, that is living image of Amun. He restored the worship of Amun god. And therefore, it is said that King Tut disturbed the pharaoh Akhenaten, and his curse was responsible for the untimely death of King Tut. What problem Carter faced when he reached the mummy of King Tut? How did he find a way out? That's a very important point to remember, that when Carter, along with his men, were working at the tomb of King Tut, they found that the ritual raisins had hardened. They had cemented the mummy of King Tut to the coffin. The solidified material could be removed through chisels. So first of all, his body was kept under the blazing heat of the sun. But when the resins couldn't be melted, then the body parts were chiseled out. The mummy was cut free. His men removed the death's head and severed every major joint. Then they kept the body in a layer of sand. It was a sandbox. He defended his act lest the mummy shouldn't fall into the hands of thieves for getting gold. As we know now that King Tut was very fond of gold, and the mummy of King Tut was decorated with precious collars, inlaid necklaces, rings, bracelets, amulets, and a ceremonial apron. There were sandals, sheets for fingers and toes, and the inner golden coffin and mask. All of them were made of pure gold. According to the beliefs, it was thought that they could take their riches with them to the great beyond, that is life after death, and that was the process of resurrection. How did Carter defend his action of cutting the mummy free? We know that he chiseled the body parts. Carter said that if he hadn't cut the mummy free, thieves would have avoided the guards and ripped it apart to remove all the gold. The mummy had been kept with a lot of wealth in the form of gold, ornaments, etc. How can CT scan prove more effective than X-rays? CT scan can prove obviously more effective because it produces hundreds of X-rays in cross-section, which are put together like slices of bread to create a three-dimensional virtual body. Now, this is an important question. Explain the statement, King Tut is one of the first mummies to be scanned in death as in life. It means that King Tut's mummy was the first one ever to be scanned. The purpose was to reveal the mysteries related to the period when he was alive and also to find out the reasons of his death in under mysterious circumstances. The death occurred only 9 years after his taking the throne. Now, what were the deeds of Akhenaten that led Ray Johnson to believe that he was Vaki? We know that Akhenaten was Amenhotep IV. But he became a bit crazy and he started attacking the idols of Amun God. He stopped the worship of Amun God, closed the temples of Amun God. He even shifted his religious capital from Thebes to Amarna and even changed his name from Amenhotep to Akhenaten. The CT scan of King Tut's mummy revealed fascinating images of Tut's body, and we know that it revealed startling facts like the front ribs were found missing, the chest bone as well. Now, curse of the pharaoh, joked the guard nervously. What is this curse and why did the guard say so? So the curse of the pharaoh, death or misfortune falling upon those who disturbed him, is considered to be true. The fans of the CT scan machine got stuck with the sand dust and stopped working during the scanning of King Tut's mummy. Then the guard jokingly said it was a curse of the pharaoh. Later, another pair of white plastic fans were arranged, which worked well enough. Now, this is a summary of the chapter in the form of gist as well as question answers. You must read the chapter as well to understand it thoroughly.
Thank you. You can contact me.